In the name of the Father, the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
In the name of the Father,
the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Come, Holy Spirit, fill the heart of your faithful and enkindle in them the fire of your divine love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who by the light of the Holy Spirit did instruct the hearts of the faithful, grant us by the same Holy Spirit to release what is right and just and always to rejoice in His consolation through Christ our Lord. Amen.
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 From the Holy Gospel according to Saint John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to Thomas, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, then you will also know my Father. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. Philip said to him, Master, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us. Jesus said to him, have I been with you for so long a time, and you still do not know me, Philip? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own. The Father who dwells in me is doing his works. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me, or else believe because of the works themselves. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes in me will do the works that I do, and will do greater ones than this, because I am going to the Father. And whatever you ask in my name, I will do, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask anything of me in my name, I will do it. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. The gospel of today is one of the seven I ams, no, in the Bible, wherein Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. I am the bread of life. I am the door. So may we have the three pointers of Titalien?
The three pointers for today's gospel. Number one, Jesus who said, I am the way, I am truth and life to Thomas. In today's gospel is also proclaiming the same truth to his apostles and to us. Number two, Jesus further reveals that he is totally united and inseparable from his Father when he said, I am in the Father, and the Father is in me. Number three, let us always be aware that to be obedient to the Father's will, we have to live in Christ-like ways. Through the power and inspiration of the Holy Spirit, who is within each of us. Ponder on the Father's will in your present life and try to sense how you are to live in Christ-like ways in the Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you so much, Tita Lien. So true. Well, no?
Yes.
The way to the Father is through Jesus with the Holy Spirit. Any reflection from Tito Mans?
Marino, I'll just read. This is a very good example.
Yeah.
One,
please.
Says, a typical marriage vows goes like this. Listen, everyone. For better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do us part. A man and a woman become one by virtue of the sacrament of marriage. Ganon din ang example dito sa gospel, that the Father and I are one. Jesus' objective for instituting the sacrament is to permanently bind the two separate and distinct individuals so that they may become one. This union must always be for life. It must never be based on convenience, but based on mutual trust and respect for each other. In the gospel for today, it is very obvious that Jesus wants to point out to Philip and to us too, that he and God the Father are one. Although God the Father and Jesus are two different persons, they are one and the same God. They both have the same desire for all of humanity, and that is the salvation for us all. We believe this oneness of Jesus and God the Father, although they are two different persons. We must also strongly believe in the sanctity of the sacrament of matrimony, that it is a union for life, and nobody can separate both spouses except mortal sin. Except mortal death. But sad to say, many of us violate the sanctity of marriage, and the result is sometimes separation. And who is to blame for this? To blame is the arrogance of many of us, for we don't want to subscribe to the laws of God. We instead follow our selfish desires, which in the end don't bring us any good, except endless misery. You will also notice in the other Gospels, in the past readings that we have, there is that for instance, this one, remain in my love if you keep my commandments, you see. You are violating a commandment if you fail to honor that vow. The vows you made in front of God. That is a covenant. Covenant cannot just be broken. A contract can be rescinded. But the covenant cannot be. That's why, if you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love. So you have to think, no? Because you are committing a violation of that commandment. And it could be it could be held against you in the end. You know, face God in the judgment. Kaya maganda example yun. That you become one flesh. Yan tinatawag na one flesh. Bakit si Adan, no? Only Eve ate the fruit. So, si Eve lang dapat nang may kasalanan doon. Bakit nadamay si Adan? Because they become one flesh. Kung anong kasalanan ng isa, maling ginawa, damay yung isa. Pati tayo, dadamay niya. See? We inherited that original sin committed by our first parent. And that's why Jesus came into this world, to save us from that sin. To restore that broken relationship with the Father, with God. He has to die on the cross because of his love for man. He doesn't need us at least, no? He created us out of love. Hindi na tayo kailangan. God is, all in all, is complete already. He doesn't need man. But because of that love, he created man. Amen.
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 Thank, Thank you, Tito Mans. Yeah, it's true. One example is the sacrament of marriage, wherein the couple is one flesh and supposedly should be together always and nothing can separate them. But there are instances wherein there are valid reasons why they do separate. But some, like me, Tita Florita, Tita Helen, have achieved that till death do us part, right?
Amen.
So, although it's hurting, but we usually, that's really our end, because our aim in this life is really eternal life. And the one who brought us, who will bring us there, will be Jesus, through Jesus to the Father with the Holy Spirit. So may we have the reflection of the Haro Cathedral, Tita Amiga Belen.
Okay. No true
Thank
friend.
Thank you, Tito Manny.
Okay. No true friend can ever abandon friendship, as God never will. That's what friends are for. A true friend would be someone who stands up for you when others would try to hurt you emotionally or even physically. He will do everything for your safety, no matter what consequence he would take as its toll. He too is not just someone who may adhere always to your likings. Convenient or not, he must be bold enough to let you be aware of your flaws. That is detrimental to your growth, even to the extent of losing the amity. Otherwise, he would end up as an accomplice to your downfall. In a like manner, God abhors your sinfulness to let you grow according to the best plan he has in store for you. His love even goes farther beyond how you define faithfulness in your limited capacity by spreading his arms on the cross. He accepts you as you are and will always stand loyal by your side. Friendship is not a matter of honor, but of commitment. Amen.
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 Thank you, Miga Belen.
Welcome, Isabel.
Nikki, do you have something to share? Muted ka, Nick.
Naka-mute.
Please unmute yourself. Naka-mute ka, Nick.
Ayaw.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. So, I will read to you the 3 points of Father Tito in his homily.
Okay.
The gospel of today is all about the imperfection of Thomas. So, number 1 point that Father Tito took up in his homily is the imperfection of Thomas, because it's the doubting Thomas. And the feast of Saints Philip and Thomas and James. And number 3, the Lord assures us that one can do greater things than what he has done. So number 1, the imperfection of Thomas. Remember that Thomas is doubting about the resurrection of Jesus. And then Father Tito also touched on the feast of Saints Philip and James. The James here is the James the Lesser, because there are 2 James, right? James the Greater, who is the son of Zebedee, and James the Lesser, who is the son of Alphaeus. And according to Father Tito, the one that is referred to here in the feast is James the Lesser. And the grace of the two the feast of the two saints they were called by the Lord as one of the apostles. So they also died a martyr's death. So actually, the imperfections of the apostles, they were called even of their imperfections because the Lord called them to mission, to spread the gospel, to cure the sick, and to bring conversion to sinners. So it is not actually the achievements that one has achieved, but rather the mission that one is being called to by the Lord. So even with Philip's imperfection, remember Philip and the feeding of the 5,000? It was Philip who said, where can we get some food to these people? Even 300, more than 300 wages cannot even give food to this multitude. So still, the imperfection of Philip was used by the Lord, no? Because he was called in to be one of the disciples who will carry on the work of our Lord, no? Even with his not really negative attitude, but imperfection. So the third point was about the Lord assuring us that we can do greater things than what he has done, because this is by the grace of God that we can do these things through what we are called in to do in the mission that the Lord has given us. And we have to discern that mission. What is the Lord's path for us? What is his mission for us to do? So we have to ask the grace of God, because it's only through the grace of God that we can accomplish the mission that he will assign us. But we have to ask the Holy Spirit. We have to pray for that. We have to pray for his grace, because it's only God's grace that can bring us to fruition in our mission. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Anything more, Tita Torita? Do you have something to share, Tita Helen?
I just want to read part of our shared reflection of one of our brothers, BCBP.
Mm-hmm.
It ends up with a concluding prayer. And could I be permitted to read?
Yeah, please.
Lord Jesus, thank you for being our way, our truth, and our life. As we honor the apostles Philip and James today, inspire us to follow in their footsteps with bold hearts and willing spirits. Strengthen all of us that we may continue to serve you in all that we do, glorifying your name with every action. We ask this in your holy name. Amen. Then may God bless it as we continue to walk in his way and bring his light to the world.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Okay, thank you, Tita Florita. Tita Helen?
Welcome. Yes, po. What touched me is about the sacredness of the sacrament of matrimony. And it is, in that for better or for worse, you know. So it's really painful if a husband passed away with at the very early age, leaving the small kids. But because of our faith and trust to him, everything was all trials were surpassed, and those loneliness for the previous 37 years was also cured because of love of the people around me. And I always say to all my friends that because of the strong family support system that made me strong also and to face everything. So I have always in my mind that someday I will be growing old talaga, maybe I could see him in heaven. But diba, we have mentioned before that we will not be, it's impossible for us to talk to our loved ones in heaven. We will be just looking at them, and maybe
we are all brothers and sisters.
Yes, yes. But in my heart, I'm still hoping that I could hug him. I could say, I still love you very much. Amen.
Wow. Amen. And what we learn is when we go back to our Creator. Then if we are purged from our sins, we go to heaven. There's no longer a relationship that we have before. We are all brothers and sisters. Yeah, we no longer say that you are my husband, you are my wife, no? That's what we learn. Tito Manny, no? We are all brothers and sisters in Christ.
Brothers and sisters.
Yeah, but
by virtue of our
your feelings, Tita Flor, are so nice, no? So we have attained the meaning of our relationship as married couples who lost their partners till death do us part. Amen.
Amen.
I want to share this with you, like, what's the meaning of seven in the seven I ams in of Jesus? Seven was symbolic in ancient Near Eastern and Israelite culture and literature. It communicated a sense of fullness or completeness. Oh, so that's where Father Danny usually use these words, no? Fullness of life, completeness of life. Seven is even spelled in the same consonants as the word, but this is in Arabic, complete or full. This makes sense of the pervasive appearance of seven patterns in the Bible. So the seven I ams: I am the way, the truth, and the life. I am the door. I am the bread of life. I am the vine. What's the other I am?
I am the
vine. Shepherd. I am the shepherd.
I am the good. I am the shepherd.
I am the gate.
I am the way, the truth, and the life. I am the gate.
The healer.
Oops.
Yeah. So, any more reflections that one would like to share? This is a very nice gospel reading of today. And I think we also read a part of this the other within the week, right? But Tito Mans, this was also read days before, Jesus being one with the Father, and Jesus even as if he was rebuking Philip, why did you ask that you want to see the Father when you have been with me for
April 27,
so long? Saturday. No? April 27, April 27 ba yung
Saturday, yes.
Yeah. This was repeated. So, when we, anything that we ask from the Father through Jesus, the Father will give us. Amen.
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 So, thank you so much for all the reflections, all the sharings. Miga Belen, may we have the closing prayer?
The closing prayer. Yes. Lord God, thank you for the gift of salvation through your Son, that it made us possible for us to gather here in your name tonight. Help us to be willing to serve others as when our efforts may go unnoticed. Help us to be gracious and forgiving of others when wrong. Lord, please grant us compassion and humility of heart in your name. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen.
And glory be.
Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning.
In the beginning is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Amen. Thank you so much, every Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you.
Good night, all.
Good night. God bless.
Bye-bye, everybody. Bye.